Welcome to the Vision Campus. Embedded vision solutions have become increasingly popular in recent years. The advantages of these systems are obvious. In addition to low material and operating costs, the embedded design also offers completely new possibilities for the use of vision systems due to its compactness. For these reasons, embedded vision systems will not only replace a large number of PC-based image processing solutions in the future, but will also enable completely new applications. It is normal and even sometimes very useful that mistakes are made when entering new technological paths, because mistakes are excellent opportunities to learn from. But you don't have to make every mistake by yourself. We show some of the most common pitfalls in system design and use of embedded vision systems and explain how to avoid these. This saves time, money, and of course a lot of nerves. Tip 1. Consider the embedded vision system as a whole. When purchasing embedded vision solutions, it is extremely important to consider the system as a whole, and not their individual key components separately. The camera in this system is more than just an accessory. In an embedded vision system, image acquisition and processing are closely linked. If a powerful processor is connected to a webcam, you usually don't get the desired result, because the whole system can only be as good as its weakest component. To work around this error, you should design your system detached from a single desired component, such as a specific SoC or sensor. It is better to go back to your application requirements and then select the individual components. Tip 2. Have the system developed by a single source. And yet another mistake is often made because embedded systems are not perceived as systems. Often the development of individual key components and technologies is carried out separately, rather than in the entire system. For example, cameras without processing or an interface without application software are tested. When implementing the overall system, the components often do not interact with each other in a high-performance manner. This delays the development project and costs, and the time to market explodes. Therefore, it is better to have the system developed by a single source and choose a development partner with proven expertise in the various fields of processing, vision, and system software. Tip 3. Know your processor architecture. Many camera modules have an image signal processor to pre-process the image data. Here, for example, the color correction or noise reduction can be done. These existing resources are often not used, or the workload is unfavorably distributed on the embedded CPU. This results in an oversized system design and thus, of course, also in excessive costs. Therefore, make yourself familiar with the performance and target functionality within the heterogeneous processor architecture. Acquire software know-how and find out where an algorithm can be calculated best. It may also need to be adapted for a dedicated processor in the system architecture to achieve optimal performance. Tip 4. Consider critical framework conditions. In the first system design approach, one often doesn't think about whether the individual components, such as sensors or SoCs, will be available over a longer period of time and in series production. The pure functionality and often also the price are instead the main focus during the first system design and prototyping. Only in the later course it turns out that the components for the series production are not available at all, or that the component was even discontinued without replacement. Often a costly redesign or reintegration of key components is then necessary. It is therefore recommended to consider critical framework conditions, such as the long-term availability of the components at an early stage of the initial system design. Also use standardized protocols and interfaces. Tip 5. Make a proof of concept. The performance of embedded vision systems is often overestimated. A development is purely made on the assumption of theoretical performance parameters. These are true for each component itself, but typically not when they work together. When the system is brought to life for the first time, it often turns out that the desired performance can't be achieved. In order to minimize risk, a proof of concept is often useful for system validation before the start of development. This may allow to replace core components early in the development process. Of course, this list is not exhaustive. There are a number of traps in the field of embedded vision systems. But don't get discouraged. The possibilities of embedded vision solutions make it worthwhile to continue working on them. Get advice for your projects and let experts help you. Thanks for watching.